on the affirmative side for eliminating the use of animals in scientific research. Our significance claims are that animal testing is brutal and inhumane. Nowadays, 95% of animals used in experiments are not protected by the Federal Animal Welfare Act, and that the use of alternative testing methods, such as the use of human cells, can replace the use of animals in scientific research. My opponent responded to our first claim by saying that animal testing can have potential effects to animals, but it is necessary for disease control and ensures food safety in humans. My reply to this is that animal testing is actually not necessary for disease control or food safety and is unnecessarily ending animal lives. According to PETA, in order to satisfy FDA data requirements, thousands of rats, mice, rabbits, dogs, and primates are killed in preclinical laboratory poisoning experiments to assess the safety of new drugs. As can be inferred, this is all preclinical and takes months, if not years, of testing. During human clinical trials, many drugs are rejected because they are toxic, and that was not exposed during the preclinical animal testing. Pets.org even stated, in fact, the FDA reported that 92 out of every 100 drugs that successfully pass animal trials can go into human clinical testing, fail during the human clinical trial phase. This successfully proves that the preclinical horrors that animals injure are most likely and most likely die from are not necessary in the first place. My opponent also mentioned that animal testing requires less time and exhibits less harm than human testing. First and foremost, there is no form of human testing that demonstrates nearly as much pain and suffering that animal testing does every single day. As for the issue of time, an article in Scientific American said, many multinational companies have embraced these alternative test methods, reducing and in some cases eliminating their dependence on animal testing. As a result, they cut costs and save time. Animal testing is expensive, slow, and because animals are not people, it is not always predictive. As for her claim that human testing exhibits more harm than animal testing, this is untrue because alternatives include computer models, in vitro testing, microdosing, and artificial human skin. All of these alternative methods would in no way endanger human lives in the way that animals are during their testing procedures. My opponent also stated that animal tests are highly reliable to predict results of different diseases in humans. First, according to Paul Furlong, a professor at Clinical Neuroimaging said, the atomic, metabolic, and cellular differences between animals and people make animals poor models for human beings. It is very hard to create an animal model that even equates closely to what we are trying to achieve in the human because we are not 70 kilogram rats. As can be observed, animal testing results are in no way reliable in predicting effects on humans. My partner's next claim was that nowadays 95% of animals used in experiments are not protected by the Federal Animal Welfare Act. The negative responded by saying that many organizations and laws in the U.S. are monitoring the Public Health Service policy on humane care and use of laboratory animals. Well, if her claim were to be true, then how is it possible that 95% of the animals used during animal testing are not protected? Even if many organizations and laws are monitoring the policy of humane care, it is having no impact. According to neves.org, it states, the law sets minimal standards for housing, feeding, handling, veterinary care, and some species like chimpanzees, their physiological well-being. As can be seen, these laws are not effective. Also mentioned in the same article under the American Welfare Act, it declares that all facilities administering animal testing must be inspected yearly by the Health Inspection Services. But with only 115 inspectors, it is nearly impossible for them to oversee more than 7,750 facilities. So although laws are being made in an attempt to protect animals, they are in no way being effective or justifiable. My partner's last significance claim was that the use of alternative testing methods, such as the use of human cells, can replace the use of animals in scientific research. My opponent's response was that the use of human cells as an alternative has not yet been proven to be safe, and that animals have similar genes to humans. According to neves.org, the use of human tissues is more accurate than animal models. For example, the lethal dose 50 test forces animals to ingest toxic and lethal substances to an endpoint of where 50% of the animals in the study died. Dr. Bjorn Ekwall developed a replacement for the LD50 test that measured toxicity at a precision rate of up to 85% accuracy, compared to the LD50 rate of 65%. This test is far more accurate than the animal models, and it uses donated human tissue rather than animals. Further, the test can target toxic effects on specific human organs, which animal testing could not do. That example in itself is enough evidence to prove that the use of human cells and tissues is proven to be useful. Next, my opponent claimed that animals share similar genes as humans for testing. Therefore, there are better alternatives. The truth is that this is a misconception. An article by Life Science said, mice or other animals in labs are not little people. In 2011, the Institute of Medicine concluded that there was no current need for chimpanzees in biomedical research. The NIH responded by retiring 90% of its chimpanzees. If humans' closest relative is not useful for human research, then why would any other species be? There are too many variables in anatomy among species to safely and predictably extrapolate data. Now returning back to the affirmative side, on the alternative to animal testing, first we said that animal testing is brutal and inhumane. Many animal experiments utilize restraining devices designed to prevent an animal from moving. Some research projects call for immobilization of specific parts of animals' bodies, heads, necks, legs, and pelvis, while other protocols involve immobilizing of an animal's entire body. Also, animals can suffer in similar ways to humans. According to news.org, experiments included immobilizing mice and rats in test tubes, shocking their feet, suspending them by their tails, and forcing them to swim to avoid drowning. Researchers claim these experiments had relevance to human anxiety and depression. So ultimately, animal testing is victimizing innocent animals that are defenseless and voiceless.